Hi everyone, I'm Amanda and welcome to my channel. Today we're making this super quick and super easy crochet beanie. This crochet beanie is ideal if you're a beginner or you're just looking for a quick and easy crochet project. The yarn that I'm using today is Crazy Sexy Wool by Wool in the Gang. It's a category 6, super bulky, super chunky yarn. For this pattern you'll need 2 skeins. I'll also be using a size O, 12mm crochet hook. All the details and links to these materials can be found in the description box below. In today's video, I'm going to be using the colour Pink Lemonade. To begin, you're going to make a slip knot and make a chain of 20. When you've made your chain of 20, you're going to do a yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the second chain from the hook. So working into the second chain from the hook, 1, 2, you're going to yarn over, insert your hook into the back loop only, yarn over and pull up a loop. You'll have 3 loops on your hook. You're then going to pull the first loop through the other 2 loops on your hook, and that's you made your first yarn over slip stitch. We'll do it again, yarn over, working into the back loop only of the next stitch, insert your hook, pull up a loop, 3 loops on your hook, pull the first loop through the other 2 loops, and that's you made your second yarn over slip stitch. You're going to repeat this into the back loop only of each chain until you get to the end of the foundation chain. When you get to the end of your foundation chain, you're going to make a yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the last chain. Then chain 1 and turn your work. For row 2, you're going to make your first yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the first stitch here. So this is the stitch that's at the base of your chain 1. The chain 1 doesn't count as your first stitch. So yarn over, insert your hook into the back loop only, pull up a loop and pull the first loop through the other 2 loops on your hook. And you're going to do this into the back loop only of each stitch until the end of row 2. When you get to the end of row 2, you're going to make your last yarn over slip stitch into the back loop only of the last stitch. Chain 1 and turn your work. What you're going to do now is you're going to repeat row 2 until your work measures 17 inches. I've now worked my rectangle, which is made up of 36 rows, which is the required number of rows for an adult size beanie. Before we move on and seam the 2 sides of the rectangle together to make the main body of the hat, I'm just going to show you how you can count your rows. So you can see here that we've got raised ridges and they're made up of little V stitches. So each ridge counts as 2 rows. You want to make sure that you've got 36 of these raised ridges, and that measures about 18 inches. We'll move on and seam the 2 ends of the beanie together. You want to make sure that your foundation yarn tail is here at the top left hand corner, and your working yarn and hook should be down here at the bottom right hand corner of your work. This is the right side of your fabric. And what we're going to do is we're going to fold it in half. So this is the wrong side. and we're going to make a slip stitch seam all the way up. So to begin the slip stitch seam, we're going to join the two ends of our work. So we're going to insert your hook into the first corner stitch here. Grab your yarn and pull up a loop. You'll have two loops on your hook. Make a slip stitch, pull the first loop through the second hoop, and we've now connected the two sides together. To join the next stitches, insert your hook into the next stitch and then come over to the other side, and we're going to be working into the back loops. So insert your hook into the back loop, yarn over, pull up a loop and pull the first loop through the second loop, and you've made the next slip stitch. And you're going to do this, making sure that all your stitches are lined up. Work into the back loop, insert your hook, yarn over, pull up a loop, and make a slip stitch. You can see that you're forming the slip stitch seam. So continue working in this way up to the top of the hat. When you get to the end of the row, you can see that we've got one stitch remaining on each side. So to make the last slip stitch, insert your hook and come over to the other side, and instead of going through the back loop as we've been doing, insert your hook under both loops. This is just to make it a bit more secure. Yarn over, pull up a loop, and then make your slip stitch. So now that we've seamed the rectangle together, we've now formed the main body of the beanie. We'll still keep the yarn attached to our hook, because what we're going to do now is make the crown of the hat. So we're going to make four very quick rounds using single crochet two together stitches. But first of all, we want to turn the hat so that the right side is now facing outwards, facing towards us. Now that you've got your hat the correct way round, come back up to the top and grab the loop with your working yarn attached, and you're now ready to start working on the crown of the hat. We're now going to begin working on the crown of the hat. So to start, chain one and then make your first single crochet into this single loop here. And I'm just going to place a stitch marker into this first stitch. And you're going to work single crochet stitches into each stitch around the top of the hat. And you can see there's only single loops here at the top. Don't worry about that, that's totally fine. Here's the next loop. When you get to the end of round one, you're going to slip stitch into the first single crochet that you made to join the round. And you should have a total of 36 stitches all the way around the top of your hat. For round two, we're going to start making decreases. So begin by chaining one, and we'll make the first single crochet two together by inserting your hook into the first stitch, which is at the base of the chain one, so right in here. Pull up a loop, then insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through all three loops. And that's the first single crochet two together complete. And again, I'll just put a stitch marker into that stitch because that's where we'll be slip stitching into at the end of round two. So for round two, you're going to continue to work the single crochet two togethers all around the top of the hat. And I'll meet you back at the end of round two once I've done all my single crochet two together stitches. At the end of round two, you should have 18 stitches. For round three, you're going to repeat round two. So you'll begin by chaining one and then work single crochet two together stitches all the way around the top of the hat. At the end of round three, you should have 9 stitches remaining. And for the final round, round four, that will be the same as rounds two and three. Begin by chaining one and then work your single crochet two together stitches all the way around the top of the hat. I'll meet you at the end of round four to show you what to do with the last stitch. At the end of round four, once you've worked your single crochet two together stitches, you'll notice that you've got one stitch remaining. For this last stitch, all you're simply going to do is work one single crochet, like so, and then slip stitch into the first stitch of the round to join. Once you've worked the last stitch, you're going to cut your yarn . Pull the yarn through and then pull it through to the inside of your hat and weave in your ends. To finish off your crochet beanie, you can attach a pom-pom to the top, and I've also rolled up the brim. It's about 2.5 to 3 inches wide. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you liked it, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching.